Lazy eye, a type of amblyopia, is a condition in which the brain and the eyes are not stimulated equally, causing the brain to favor one eye over the other.
The brain basically learns to ignore the signal from the weak eye, and so the individual becomes monocularly blind. Amblyopia is very easy to reverse in children, but almost impossible to reverse in adults because adult brains lose plasticity to allow it to reverse.
If patients are young, this condition can be treated by patching the strong eye, forcing the brain to readjust the input from the weak eye. But as the patients age, it becomes increasingly more difficult to fix, though there still may be a solution: total darkness.
We teamed up with a great group from SUNY Optometry that's led by Ben Backus. We're currently running an NIH-sponsored clinical trial to ask if visual deprivation can enhance plasticity in the visual cortex of adults, and if we can use that plasticity to reteach amblyopic humans how to see.
But before this idea could be applied to human subjects, it had to first be tested on rodents in a lab setting.
We've reduced visual experience by putting our test subjects, in this case rodents, in the dark. So by reducing visual input, by placing the subjects in the dark, we were able to get the visual parts of their brain to re-express plasticity like a juvenile.
After the success of these laboratory experiments, it was clear that humans were the next step.
So adult amblyopes that have been told that they're too old to have their amblyopia reversed are being placed in the dark for 10 days. And we're testing the idea that that visual deprivation is going to enhance plasticity enough that we can reteach the weak eye how to see. This is a really exciting example of translational work, taking results from a basic science lab like mine and translating that to clinical practice and clinical trials.
Subjects in the experiment lived in a completely blacked out residence for 10 days.
We've tested this in several human subjects, some amblyopic human subjects and some non-amblyopic human subjects, and they tolerate being in the dark very well. They learn how to navigate based on touch and also based on sound. It's a very structured time in the dark. We have exercise time, they have books on tape.
Instead of being bored or claustrophobic, the test subjects found the experience to be calming and stimulating. Some even experienced vivid hallucinations in the absence of visual input.
Every person who's been in the dark so far has said it was an enjoyable experience, and they came out of the dark more relaxed than when they went in the dark.
For more than a decade, Quinlan's lab has worked on treatments for amblyopia using rodents. Quinlan is hopeful that the promising results in mice and rats might one day translate to success in human subjects. When it comes to rodents,
visual deprivation rejuvenated the brain. Importantly, this plasticity that we could re-engage with visual deprivation was sufficient to allow us to teach the amblyopic subjects how to see.